corner into the spacious curious drawing room and tidy that hair.
Mary, darling?
Yes?
I'm an exceedingly handsome chap from Modern Home magazine. I was immediately attracted by this magnificent mansion on the hill and would dearly love to feature it in our September issue.
How simply marvellous. Do come in, Mr...
Bone Crusher.
Abel. Bone Crusher.
My, this is an attractive room. So nice to see a house with good crackling fireplace. But I'm especially charmed by the Queen Anne upright chairs. May I sit down?
No, they've just been varnished.
Hello.
That's Bingo. He's a dinky little darling, don't you think?
I like him. I like him very much. I had a puppy once. I liked him. I liked him a lot. I liked to hug him. People say I don't know my own strength, Mrs. Darling. I hugged him, and hugged him, and hugged him, and after that he didn't seem to want to go for walks anymore. He didn't want to eat. He didn't want to lick my face. He just slept and slept and slept. He slept for 2 whole years. Do you think he was tired from all the hugging?
I expect he was, Mr. Bone Crusher. Now, I'm sure your readers will be interested in the sophisticated French windows. They're all the rage this season, I'm told. Oh, excuse me, Mr. Bone Crusher. Laura, the door. She's such a scatterbrained child. I mean,
I'll handle this. Just keep your bloody damn blasted mouth shut.
Ah, there's a firestorm a-brewing out there. Sorry to bother you, Mr. and Mrs. Darling, but I'm afraid there's been a spot of butter down at the village, and we're looking for an escaped crazy nutcase. A mad psycho on the run. Ken what I mean? All right, bloody comedian. You not have noticed anything of strange of late, have you, laddie?
No, everything here has been lovely.
Right you are then, sir. And you, Mrs.?
She's seen nothing.
Can the lassie not speak for herself, sir?
No, my hands are over her mouth.
Right you are then, sir. Well, if you do not happen to notice anything of a particularly strange nature, please do not hesitate to contact me at my rather quaint police station. The number's Fambright 206. Just ask for PC Smart. Cheerio! Ba-da-ba-ba-ba.
Now I'm going to release my grip, if you should scream.
Now, as I was saying, I really should replace that girl, Laura. She is impossible.
She's feeble-minded, but charming all the same. Now who will that be?
Oh, my darling husband, Tom. I do so love him.
One squeak out of you and you'll surely will never see him again.
Hello? Anyone home? Hello? It's me, Tom, darling. Tall?
Yes.
Handsome?
Yes.
Husband of the charmingly pretty Mary, darling.
Lucky her.
Is anyone home?
Hello, Tom. Nice afternoon.
Tiring, Uncle, tiring.
Yourself?
Very pleasant, old boy. I've been stuffing an elephant's head all day. Shot the old boy in Africa. Whoa. 40 years ago. Left the blasted thing in my bedroom. Forgotten all about that silly damn blighter till today. You look bloody good in your bedroom. What do you think, Tom? Next to that rhino I gave you last year?
I'll think it over, Uncle. Is my darling wife Mary around?
I haven't heard so much as a squeak out of her all day, old boy.
Oh, Tom, darling! Thank God you're home!
Darling, what's all this fuss? I've only been gone a few hours.
There's a beastly man upstairs, and he's trying to kill me!
Nonsense, darling!
Fiddlesticks, Mary.
He said he's going to kill us all!
Darling, what a frightful imagination you have. Maybe you should be the writer.
But I'm not imagining it. He's out there now. Oh, Tom, he's going to kill me. He is!
Oh, he is he?
Nonsense!
But the wicked man said he was going to listen to
Twaddle! Uncle's right, it is sheer nonsense. You're just overdoing things again, playing the phonogram and having strenuous afternoon naps.
Are you sure, Tom?
Of course I'm sure. I'm your husband, aren't I? Now don't you worry your pretty little head about it.
I'm sorry for being such a silly girl, Tom.
That's quite right. I'm glad you're silly. You know I wouldn't have married you if you weren't silly. Now how about nipping upstairs and fetching me my slippers, silly girl?
Of course, Tom. Have you had a hard day, darling?
Oh, rather. The blasted publishers have been asking my advice on the blinking typeface of my new novel. Murder is illegal.
Disgraceful.
Oh, you poor, poor thing.
Nasty business, Tom. Nasty business.
Yes, typography does strain one's nerves.
Damnable nuisance, Tom.
Yes?
Oh, downright filthy if you ask me, you poor devil.
Quite.
A stinking bad luck, you old bugger.
Well, calm down, Uncle. It's not that bad.
Of course it is, Tom. It's bloody horrific. Anyway, I thought your new novel was entitled Stabbed by a Gun.
No, Uncle, that was the one I wrote last week.
I see.
Hello?
Oh, Tom! Tom! It's him! The wicked man!
Abel, it's been years.
But you haven't changed one bit, Tom.
Tom, that's him, the wicked man.
Nice to see you then, wicked man.
Likewise, old sport.
You know the fiend?
Know him? We were best friends at university. Abel Bonecrusher, practical joker extraordinaire. For the first 2 years, nobody understood a word old Abel here said, because he pretended he was Dutch. But he wasn't. Oh, how we all laughed. But I'll never forget the time, though. Never. That you hid in a desk for a year. And then finally you sprang out, just when everyone thought you were dead. Oh, how we all laughed.
Sounds like a damned impractical joker, if you ask me.
I'm not mad, Mrs. Darling. Just amusing.
Please, do not be disturbed by my looks. I may look like a monster, but I assure you, underneath I am the same as you or I. I am Detective Inspector Harry Story, Scotland Yard. My car's stuck in a ditch a half a mile down the road, and so I've come for the use of your telephone. Sorry if I startled you.
Good God, man, you must be the ugliest fellow that ever lived!
There was a man living in Cornwall in the 13th century. Now, I don't know how far one can go on rumour and hearsay, but apparently this man was so damned ugly, he could only get employment as a scarecrow. Damned ugly scarecrow, by all accounts. And he didn't just scare away crows. He scared away every species of bird within a 10-mile radius. The insect population multiplied like nobody's business. Soon the whole ecosystem became imbalanced and the bug-infested crops had to be destroyed. The villagers weren't easy on the poor blighter. They sawed off his head and hosted the biggest damned inter-village five-a-side football tournament the county had ever seen. Some bloody good goals by all accounts. They buried his body in the churchyard. No problem on that score, but his head was destined for an altogether less holy resting place. They dug a hole a mile deep in the village green, into which they tossed the poor blighter's noggin. Then, for 10 years, every man, woman, and child urinated on it 3 times a day. I hope you can treat me in a more civilized fashion. After all, it's not the Middle Ages, is it?
What's your bloody face, man?
You've almost frightened the life out of us.
How dare you bring that thing this close to decent, law-abiding people.
Well then, Abel, you better take my wife here for a stroll. His face may interfere with any unborn children.
I'll show you the family jewels, Mr. Bonecrusher.
Oh, I'd like that very much.
Good God, man, what did you do to deserve a face like that? I mean, I've seen more attractive men in Scotland. There's a joke going round the taverns just now, something about teaching one's arse to speak. Heard of it, have you?
My gross disfigurement doesn't interfere with my ability to carry out my duties as a police officer. That's what has brought me to the village of Farnborough today. Someone, possibly still in this village, has killed a large number of people in an unspeakably brutal fashion.
How many people has this diabolical fellow killed, might I ask?
We don't know. Could be 5. Could be 6. Could be 12. Could be a baker's dozen. He could have killed a dozen bakers. We just don't know.
Such strange happenings, Inspector.
Yes. Mr. Darling, do you know the name Dracula?
Dracula?
Dracula. Come. Dracula.
Seems a rather silly name to me. No, I can't say I have. Why?
You surprise me, Mr. Darling. Hollywood has made over 2,000 films using him as the main character. But the gist of it was that he, Count Dracula, would suck the blood of his victims.
Are you suggesting, then, this Count Dracula thing is killing people from the village?
I am merely suggesting, Mr. Darling, that we are dealing with a similar evil.
Why, that's just a load of mumbo-jumbo. Belongs between the pages of Tom's Arum Scarum novels. Bah! That's just gibbering jungle talk. Hocus pocus, voodoo, blatant tomfoolery, far-fetched, fiddle-faddle, fudge, bosh, bollocks, dummy rot.
Calm down.
All this talk about goblins and fairies.
Well, no one said anything about goblins and fairies, Uncle.
Spooks and spirits.
Uncle?
Demons and devils.
Uncle, take a slug of your meds and do shut up.
Fiddlestick. Oh, good idea, Tom.
What in the name of please?
Oh, that's just Michael Hennig, the mad professor.
You have a mad professor living here? Can I see him?
No, you can't actually. No one can see him. About 15 years ago, after a lifetime of research, he finally managed to turn himself invisible, and he's now working on phase 2 of that experiment.
Hence the explosion.
But he's harmless, Inspector. Not like our killer, who must be caught and hanged by the neck. I must get my glasses seen to. Through these? You look like a squealing hog caught in a trap, and that can't be right.
It's terrible business, terrible business. Me? I'm the cheery type. Never dwelling on the morbid. They'll remember it will get to the stage where no one in this village will want to go out. For fear they too will be crushed to a pulp.
I didn't say how they had been killed, Mr. Darling.
Well, I must have read that in the papers.
It won't appear until the late edition, sir.
Well, whoever it is, I do hope you can catch him quicker than they can print it. So long as he's on the loose, not a person in the village will be safe.
The fact that each victim has been a person has been a closely guarded secret, Mr. Darling.
Well, I don't understand, though. What kind of man would do such a thing, then? Leave a childish rhyme on the body of each victim? Seems to me a rather silly and strange thing to do, no?
Again, I never said this particular practice was performed, sir.
Well, I just assume.
You assume a lot of things, darling.
No need to get stroppy, honey.
Oh, my, it's Billy Croft, the Andy man. He's dead, he is, he's dead. Oh, my, it was horrible.
That is nasty business. But hurry up and finish making my dinner, though. What do you think I pay for, being fat?
I found him in the pantry, being into a pulp. Hardly recognisable he was.
How did you recognise him then, cook?
Well, he always looked like a pulp. Very slovenly of face he was. A bit like yourself, sir. Terrible business. Me, I'm the cheery type. Always laughing, yeah. I found this note on his body, sir.
Seems to be in the form of a simple child's rhyme. Not last night, but the night before, three little monkeys came to the door and crush me to a pulp. Interesting meter. You did it, cook. You always hated him, didn't you? Hated him with every bone in your body. You couldn't stand it any longer, so you grabbed him. He screamed. You told him to be quiet, but he wouldn't, so you hit him. Something took you over, something you didn't understand. You saw yourself doing it, but you didn't believe it was you. But he still wouldn't be quiet, and so you hit him again. And again, and again, and again, and you didn't mean to, but you killed him! You lost your mind and you killed him with your bare hands, didn't you, cook?
I did not, sir.
Oh, well, it's always worth a try. What was this chap's name, did you say?
Billy Gruff, sir.
Billy Gruff. And did he have a middle name?
Gates! Begging your pardon, sir. Billy Gates Gruff.
Oh, hello, and what's your name, you rather dotty gal?
Laurie Scribbles, sir. Begging your pardon.
Scribbles. Well, that's odd. I can hardly read that. And your name, cook?
Me, sir. Mrs. Meals, sir.
And tell me, Mrs. Meals, did you see anything strange this afternoon?
No, sir. Keeps myself to myself, I did.
Very kind of you, I'm sure. And you, Laura?
I'd like to eat a large selection of cakes.
Go away, Mrs. Meals.
As you wish.
Now, Laura, as I was saying, did you hear anything funny this afternoon?
No, sir. I was listening to Tommy Trinder on the radio, sir.
So you didn't hear any shouts, screams, calls?
Could you run that list by me again? Begging your pardon, sir.
Why, certainly, Laura. Shouts, screams, calls?
One more time, if you don't mind, sir.
If you wish, Laura. Shouts, screams, I'm just wasting my time here, aren't I? Fetch me Mrs. Darling, I'd like to ask her a few questions. And do something about that hair.
Yes, sir!
Inspector! My wife is a very delicate and ladylike woman. It's not a very feminine thing to be discussing such morbid subjects. And besides, she is showing my friend the family jewels.
She's taking her time.
She was born feet first and tends to do things rather slowly. A heartless but nonetheless true statement of fact.
It's true, sir. No Albert Einstein was she.
Laura, you speak anyone spoken to, is that clear?
Is what clear, sir?
So stop insulting my wife, Laura.
Sorry, sir.
And what do you mean no Albert Einstein was she, eh?
Oh, this note was found on her body. Begging your pardon, sir.
Tea and then what?
I left and then curtsied, sir.
Shouldn't you curtsy first, then leave?
I did never have any complaints from Mrs. Darling when she was alive, sir.
This is irrelevant, Inspector.
Oh, please, bear with me, Mr. Darling. Now, Laura, did you notice anything strange about Mrs. Darling whilst you were in the room?
I don't recall, sir.
Come on, think, girl, think.
Well, now that I come to think of it.
Come on, try and remember.
Well, she did seem to be.
Try and remember!
She looked like she was.
Think, damn you, think!
You're not giving me a chance.
She's hysterical!
Oh, no. Please, will you leave this to me, Mr. Darling? Go and have a few puffs on your pipe. No, there's a good chap. Now, Laura, you were saying?
Well, now that it comes to think of it, there was something odd.
Yes?
A vicious madman had his evil hands around her delicate neck.
Begging your pardon, sir.
Dad's dad's dog. It always seems a decidedly decent dog to this detective.
Both of you please shut up about Ken Dodd's dad's dog. I'm glad the damn Dalmatian's dead.
Oh, come on, Mr. Darling, you're just in a bad mood. I'm sure when you look back at this in a few years' time, you two will see the funny side of it all.
Oh, please, concentrate on your job, Inspector.
Say cool, Mr. Darling. Hang loose. Now, Lauren, how would you describe this man? Was he broad?
Broad, sir.
Yes, did he have large pectorals?
Oh, I don't know, sir. He kept his trousers on all the time I was there.
That's it! No more questions! Laura, get down to the blaster cellar and fetch me my brandy, you stupid girl!
Yes, sir!
Is that wise? The murderer could be lurking down there. I was sure I could hear noises coming from below.
No, that would have been the sound of shutters banging.
But I was sure I heard voices, sounded like a man and a woman.
Well, that's what I'm saying. It'd be Shudders and his girlfriend. It is the butler's day off, you know? Here he is now, coincidentally. Hello, Shudders. Enjoying your day off?
Yes, thank you, sir.
You're very sinister-looking, Shudders.
Yes, I suppose you could say I'm a bit of a square-shouldered, rough diamond. I heard the bad news. My grave condolences, sir.
Oh, bad luck.
I suppose I'm a suspect?
Everyone is. Shudders, can I take down your particulars?
Inspector!
I didn't mean that one!
My name is Shudders. I speak slowly, with only the slightest hint of a foreign accent.
And?
That's it, sir. That sums me up completely.
I see. Now, Shudders, can you give me a brief account of your movements this afternoon?
A sort of rhythmical up and down, sir.
Well, Inspector, you're just feeding these people these lines now, eh?
Mr. Darling, I've had a very sad life. The only woman that ever kissed me was my mother. So please don't deny me the small pleasure the innuendo affords me. It's the only thing that brings me comfort.
Well then, man. I'm sorry. I didn't realise.
It's okay, look at that. I'm okay now. I hope that your attic is sizable. I fear that before Dawn returns with her comforting light, there will be many more murders in this nightmarish mansion.
Nightmarish mansion? Don't get carried away, Inspector. You've been reading too many tatty little thrillers. This is a charming and elegant home, and I myself choose all the furnishings and objets d'art for their unpretentious lightness. IKEA.
And what's that?
That's just a conversation piece.
I see. Oh, put the bloody thing down, Shutters, will you?
Hello! I'm Tom's nephew, young Danny Travis. I'm a charming, rather vague man in my late teens, stroke early 20s. I'm here to stay the weekend. Golly, what a super house. I'm especially charmed by the crystal chandelier. Yes, all in all, a charming and comforting room. Pity about the ugly bed by the fireplace there.
You've arrived at rather an unfortunate time, Mr. Young Danny Travis. Mr. Darling's wife has just been murdered.
Gosh, yes. Terrible business. Me, I'm the cheery type. Always beat you out of rhythm of my ties. Go, man, go.
Okay, young Danny, okay.
Yeah, yeah.
Danny.
Take me home, Daddy.
Danny!
Yes? Any requests?
Do you know who killed Mrs. Darling?
I don't think so, but you hum it and I'll join in.
Take off that, Sonny Jim! Now listen here. Did you, young Danny Travis, see anyone suspicious in or near the grounds as you came in?
Yes! Yes, I did, actually. I saw a strange man stride, stroke, saunter, as I came in towards the stables.
How would you describe him?
Badly, I should think. I failed my standard grade English.
The stables, eh?
Yes.
Shutters! Take me to the stable, man! Good morning!
Morning? I've been up 12 hours already. Nearly time for supper.
My, these grounds are exceptionally beautiful. A charming old well, and stables made from ancient timbers. This place carries an enormous charm.
Are you gay, Inspector? Because poet music don't feed horses. This is honest, hard work. Something you city folk wouldn't understand.
I may not be of the country, but that doesn't mean I don't appreciate the feel of a good sturdy implement in my hands.
You remind me of the officer and my comrades at certain dish, while he sat back and smoked his pipe.
Calm down, old boy.
Us men the fighting. You guys sat back and watched. Lambs to the slaughter.
And there's been a fair bit of that in Farmbright of late. You're out here in the fresh air all day, you must see a lot.
I see horse, Inspector. Horse and eh, that's all.
Of course, only a strong man could have crushed those people. I see you've got strong and calloused hands, Mr. Horseman.
I've a strong and gentle hand, Inspector. They call me Gentle John round here. Now put your back into it, man.
Gentle? I detect a lot of pent-up violence.
I don't like your tone, Inspector.
I suppose a brutal man like you enjoy the war with all the killing and such.
What are you trying to suggest, Inspector?
That you can't shake the demons of war! You're my number one suspect, Sonny Jim. And now I'm off to question suspect number two. The other brutal person of this household.
This is me as a cook.
The one and only.
I like horses. I like them a lot. I had a horse once.
If you want help, you can crush up from the door to the fold. She's been on the poorly side this morning. You'll have to use a mortar, though. The oats are down there.
Mr. Bowcrusher, I said down there! No, Mr. Bowcrusher! No!
Some tea, Inspector?
Why, yes, Mrs. Beals, that would be lovely.
I don't mind telling you, Inspector. My nerves in a right sorry state. It's been quite a day, it has.
You can say that again. But for the sake of your comic credibility, I wouldn't advise it.
Such terrible goings-on. Only a scoundrel could have killed those poor souls.
Yes. How would you describe yourself, Mrs. Meals?
I'm a cheery but practical woman, with a large ruddy face. And for your information, I couldn't hurt a fly. But if you want my advice, I'd look at Tom's black sheep of a sister. Always stealing my sherry, that one is.
Does that make her capable of murder, Mrs. Meals?
I do believe it does, Inspector. It's the devil's juice, and make no mistake. Now, can you pass me that extremely large cookbook down from the shelf, Ugly? I can't remember if it's one or two spoonfuls of yeast extract.
Oh, it can take you ages to find it in this. It's such a large, blinking book.
Two spoonfuls. Will that be all, Inspector?
Oh, it certainly will not, Mrs. Meals. You can ladle me out a bowl of that piping hot soup you've just made.
A pleasure, sir. Would sir like to eat a large selection of cakes as well?
Shut up, Mrs. Meals! Oh, hello, Bernie! Come to steal some cakes?
I like cooking. I like it a lot. I had a pizza once.
That's good. You can give me a hand. You can start by crushing up some garlic. Why are you looking at me like that, sir? Noise in the garlic, Mr. Bonkershaw!
Mr. Darling, Mrs. Meals mentioned your alcoholic sister. If she's up, I'd like to ask the broken down drunk a few questions.
Well then, Laura, send for Mr. Garyotype.
Right away, sir!
Though, Inspector, I must warn you, my sister has a manly stride and a modern manner. An unconventional sort? Yes. The blackest of sheep, certainly. But I may even go so far as to say she's,
Yes?
She's newfangled.
Bloody hell!
I heard about Mary. What a shame! Bloody hell, you're...
Yes, I'm damned ugly, you don't have to tell me. Straight away, I can see you've got a breezy, flip personality.
Drunkenness is a major part of my character.
Yes, now tell me. Can you tell me where were you this afternoon?
Wait, she was in bed with that headache.
Is that Michael Headache? The invisible professor? I'm sorry, darling, this may be none of my business, but this seems very immoral.
Yes, you're right. It is none of your business!
And since when were you called darling?
Ever since my blouses became too tight, Inspector! Why, Inspector, your face has turned a rich shade of scarlet.
That's because you've given me a beamer.
Well, I shan't stay around here and aggravate anyone's beamer, old boy.
I'm afraid there's been another murder, sir. This time it's Gentle John, the stableman. This note was found in one of his Wellingtons.
Yeast, yeast, yeast. Johnny's head is rather creased. Another fine sample of verse. Yeast. Shall I fetch me Mrs. Meals, the cook?
I'm afraid that will be impossible, sir. You see, she's dead. I got to her just as she was speaking our last words.
And what were they, Shudders?
Well, she asked me.
Yes?
To ask you.
Yes?
Whether you would like to eat a large selection of cakes.
And what did I say?
You said drop dead, Mrs. Williams, and she did.
So I killed her?
Certainly looks that way, sir.
My God! Where did you find her, Shudders?
In my wardrobe, sir.
In your wardrobe, 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 Shudders?
Yes, I opened the wardrobe door.
And then the body fell out. Well, yes, that's very common in
no,
the...
No, Inspector. I opened the door, took out a pair of boots, closed the door, put the boots on, and made to leave. But catching my reflection in the mirror, I noticed I had two odd boots on, so I went back, opened the door, and then the body fell out. Now she had this note attached to her body, sir.
Roses are red, the cook is dead. Another fine poem. Roses. Shutters, take me to the gardener.
The gardener, sir.
Yes, Shutters, the gardener.
The gardener, sir.
Yes, Shutters, the gardener.
The gardener.
Oh, shut up, Shutters, and take me to the bloody gardener.
This way, sir. The gardener, sir.
My name is Detective... My name is Detective... My name is Detective Story Scotland Yard. And your name is?
And my name is what?
That's what I'm asking. What is it?
Janie Skackle, sir.
Skackle? Can you spell that?
No, sir.
Well, then I'm sure you're very good at weeding the garden.
No, sir.
Oh, well then I'm sure you're a very nice person.
No, sir, and if you excuse me, I work today for Mr. Darling.
Regarding Mr. Darling, Jeannie, what do you know of him?
Well, he's the master of the house, isn't he? He sells words for a living, doesn't he?
Such a charming naivete.
Aye!
Just one more question, noble gardener. Did you hear any strange sounds this afternoon?
Well, you know what you mentioned, and at 5 o'clock when I was on the compost heap, I did hear something rather peculiar. Strange footsteps, with nobody making them.
Such as might be made by an invisible man. How did you know it was 5 o'clock, gardener? You don't wear a watch. I'd be surprised if you could even tell the time.
Oh, I knew for certain it was 5. That's when I always go, regular as clockwork.
Can you believe this? I'm sorry, you'll have to excuse me. I must go. Innuendo I like, but this is... I'm sorry, everybody.
Oh, are you? The only thing you should apologize about is your face, pal.
I hope you're next, Scackles. I really hope you're next. Now, how does one go about finding an invisible professor? Oh, hello, Bernie!
I like flowers. I like them a lot. They're very delicate.
Well, growing flowers takes a lot of skill, stranger. Could you crush up some of that or some? Makes a great fertilizer.
Now, this is the first time in my career that I've had to interview somebody that I couldn't see, Professor. But I'll carry on regardless.
Make it quick. I'm a busy man.
Now, I'm sure you'll have heard about all of the recent mad multiple murders.
Terrible business. Me, I'm the cheery type. Everything is awesome. Everything is cool when you're part of the team.
I'm sure you'll also realize that you have a natural advantage over everyone else. You could kill without being seen. No one knows you could be at any given time. You could just as easily... See? This just illustrates my point perfectly. Can you tell me where you were this afternoon?
I was in the 4:20 train from London.
Ah! I don't believe you. I sense much ruthlessness charm hiding behind that charming little goatee beard. Oh! So that's your game, is it? All right, then. Put your jukes up. Had enough, have you? Oh! All right, Professor. The kid gloves are off. Stop hitting yourself! Stop hitting yourself! Stop hitting yourself! Oh, one! At two!
Hector! You're nutter!
Yes, well, I have just been wrestling the Invisible Professor.
I'm very pleased for you.
Yes, well, I won.
Inspector, the man's 97 years old. Of course he won. Oh, and Jeannie the gardener, she was found on the compost heap.
My, that's blasted unfortunate.
Why, I'm beginning to like you, Inspector. Let's train you!
But I don't know how.
Shut up and dance!
Scientist searching for the secret to life fell into a seamy half world and then...
Very interesting, I'm sure, Inspector. But I fail to see what this has to do with the case.
Do you, Mr. Garyotype? Or should I say, Herr Schwitters? For you're a mad, struck-off doctor! Etc, etc, etc.
I need it. But I steal. They don't kill anyone!
Then who did?
Will I see Mama in heaven, Papa? Of course, you'll tell me, of course, but for now, the nice little inspector would like a nice little chat with you. Would that be all right?
Of course, Papa.
Hello there, young Tommy. And what did we do at school today?
You weren't there, stupid. And if you were, you wouldn't have to ask, would you?
Papa? Looks like he was born inside out.
Look, young Tommy, half a crown.
Look, young Tommy, half a crown.
Don't you want it?
Don't you want it?
I'd like to ask you a few questions.
Can you whistle? I can whistle.
Why, yes, young Tommy, I can.
Oh. Very good.
Well, I have a gun. Bang, bang!
Yes, that's a splendid gun you have there, young Tommy.
Bang, bang, bang!
Now, Tommy, can you tell me if you heard anything strange this afternoon?
Bang, bang, bang!
As I said, Tommy, it's a splendid gun.
Now, bang, 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 bang!
It's not that splendid.
Bang, 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 bang,
bang! Bang!
Inspector!
I never touched him!
You're really big, aren't you? Really big. How would you like if some big brute lad handled you, eh? Beating you and humiliating you? How would you like that, Inspector?
Very much. Yes, very much. Of course, the pretty packet, though. Straight sex is pretty cheap these days, but for something a bit, you know, special, you really have to shell out, don't you find?
I can't believe what you're saying.
I know, it's true. I remember you could get trussed up and beaten for 10 shillings. Now it's at least a guinea, and these modern skinny tarts have no muscle, no stamina. Yes, you share my revulsion. Give me a strongly built woman with a bit of severity any day. I meant to ask you, Mr. Darling, did you ever, you know, Mrs. Meals?
Why, you filthy
old... Oh, you did, didn't you, you lucky beggar!
Oh, excuse me, sir, but did young Danny Travers used to be alive?
Pardon, Laura?
Young Danny Travers, sir. He hasn't always been dead, has he?
What?
It's just I found his body in the conservatory when I was in the hall dusting the library.
Well, that's it, Inspector. We're all going to die now.
Now, Laura, just prior to finding him, did you hear any screams? And if you did, at what time did you hear them?
It was 11:27, sir. Exactly. But I didn't hear any screams.
You didn't?
Yes.
Is that yes you did or yes you didn't?
That's yes I ain't, but did not hear that ever, sir.
That doesn't make any sense.
I'm a surrealist. Begging your pardon, sir.
I think I'll join in on this witty banter. Now, you didn't hear any screams at exactly 11:27. What time was that, roughly?
It might have have been 11:27, sir. I'm not sure.
And what were you doing at 11:27?
I was looking at my watch.
What time is it then?
I don't recall. It might have been 6:30.
Well, what were you doing at 6:30?
Inspector, young Danny's dead now, and you're just questioning Laura for the sheer blasted fun of it.
Guilty.
If I get killed, sir, can I have the deal?
Laura, you're fired.
Oh, thank you, sir.
Now, one of you is the killer. Just who, I don't know. Yet. But one of you, darling, daguerreotype, uncle, shutters, scribbles, bone crusher, is the killer. And I know what you are going to say, but names can be misleading. You should not always look for the obvious. My last case, for example, the suspects included Alistair Madman, James Death, and Lawrence Evil. But it was a chap named Peter Innocent who was the real killer. But this is a simple case, a very simple case. So simple that I can't work it out. This is a hard case, a very hard case. I like the easy ones best, I can do them. The hard ones, not so much. The easy ones, no problem. But the hard ones, oh! Of course, we could just blame it on the little boy, you know?
That's it, Inspector. You've been just wasting our time now with jokes of rather disgusting nature, while we are standing around like idiots waiting to get killed.
I still think you're doing all of this, darling.
You're thicker than Shutters, aren't you? You were with me when my wife was killed.
I only have your word for that. You know, I read one of your books once. A high-pitched, suspenseful thriller whose blood-curdling narrative kept me leashed to my armchair. It was set in an asylum, Mr. Darling. Frightening, yes, but I never thought its author capable of murder in the three-dimensional sense. That is, until today. Tom!
Surely you're not suggesting I did all this, eh?
Do you know the name of that book, darling?
Man, I've written over 800 novels. How could I be expected to remember them all, eh?
Then let me refresh your memory. It was called The Bone Crusher.
Oh, that seems to ring a bell.
What's that, darling? We didn't quite catch that.
I just said I'm off to the library to write my newest novel, and I don't want to be disturbed.
Then don't think about all the gruesome murders you've committed.
You've the devil in you, Tom, darling.
I should never have allowed you to marry Mary.
Uncle, can't you see what he's trying to do, eh? The oldest trick in the book. Turn them all against one another. How do we even know he's a real detective, eh?
You think he might just be pretending? Might just be kidding on? Just joshing us? Spinning us a yarn? Pulling our leg? Well, if he is, he's quite good at it, Tom.
Need I remind you, Inspector? The murders only began when you arrived.
Yes! Just who are you, Inspector? Where do you come from?
I told you, my car's stuck in a ditch a half a mile down the road and...
What? You don't expect us to believe that, Inspector, do you? I sent Shutters down the road to see. There's no car in any of the many ditches that surround this house. Why, I don't think you've been in a ditch in your life. I don't think you even know what a ditch is. And for that matter, I don't think you're a member of the constabulary or even own a car. I don't like you, Inspector. I don't like your mind and I don't like your manner. I don't like your shirt. I don't like your tie. I don't like your jacket. But I pretended earlier I didn't like his moustache, Uncle, but that's quite nice. But I don't like your hair. I don't like your face. And I don't like the way you walk. But I quite like your pipe.
I quite like your pipe.
You do?
Yes, of course I do.
Really?
Yes, really.
You're not just saying that.
It's a delightful pipe. It's a wonderful pipe. It's possibly the most divine pipe I've ever seen in my life.
Oh, excuse me, Inspector. Sorry to interrupt. But I found this in the hall.
Young Tommy, is he all right?
Put it this way, it doesn't fit anymore.
Tommy!
Ah!
That's it, Inspector. I've grown tired of this. I'm going to go and kill myself.
Inspector, hurry up and solve this case. I'll have none of us left.
Right.
must get to work. Right. No, damn it, I still have no bloody idea who did it. You don't like living things, do you, Uncle? The stuffed tiger and elephant heads that adorn the walls of this mansion are ample evidence of that fact. You're not happy until something's stuffed and mounted, are you?
If this is some kind of joke, I find it an extremely poor taste. You are a very impudent young man, Inspector. I may be fiendishly bad-tempered, but I didn't kill all those people.
Didn't you?
No.
Then tell me what you were doing this afternoon.
I was out jogging. I was...
Just as I thought.
Uncle, well, I pretend for 40 years that you couldn't walk.
I couldn't think of anything else to do with my life. But I didn't kill Mary, nor the rest.
Didn't you, Uncle? Or should I say, Auntie? For that moustache is fooling nobody.
I admit it. I am a woman. My real name is Miss Bunty MacPierce, and my hobbies are needlepoint and cake eating. Does anyone want anything at the shops?
No, thanks, Huggy.
Strange woman, but as harmless as a common household fly.
Excuse me, sir, but I found these in the hallway.
It's the invisible professor's legs!
My God!
That's not all, sir. Look behind you.
Bloody hell, it's the poor blighter's torso!
And here's one of his arms!
And here's another! Okay. Okay. Now let's just put him down. Gently. I feel a prayer is in order here. Anyone know any? No? Apt words? Susan? Shutters? Yeah. Jokes? Anyone know any good jokes? For this wretched man, this poor... Hold on! Where's the poor blighter's noggin? Oh, well found, Boney! Don't worry, Boney, I'll fetch it! Hold on a minute! It's just occurred to me who did it! It was you! My sister and I have been watching you all night. You haven't laughed once!
During the excitement of the play, you've been sneaking off into the wings and killing us all! One by one.
You thought you were above suspicion.
You thought you'd get away with this, didn't you? Danger! It's a prison for you.
I had you earmarked from the start, Sonny Jim.
You think this is all one big joke, don't you?
Well, no, it doesn't. That's a good point.
You bloody, god-bloody killer!
You did it!
Well done, Inspector. Another case wrapped up.
Cough the bastard, Phony! Why, Sergeant Bone Crusher of the Art! Oh, what a merry ending! Just one more thing, Susan. Will you marry me?
Okay.
Yes!
And Mr. Bone Crusher, will you marry me?
Pleasure of sport!
A double, Willie!
Hurrah!